making his way to the ring from Lithuania, Simas Bolosinas.
Here's the 31-year-old Lithuanian journeyman. He applies his trade solely here in the UK. This fight is number 110, with previous opponents including the likes of Ahara Davis, Lewis Ritson, Lee Wood, Jordan Gill, Kid Galahad. He's only ever been stopped 8 times in those 110 fights, and the last man to do so was Rhys Mould back in 2017. The word durable epitomises this man. And I'll tell you something, he's playing to the crowd as well, throwing a little bit of Neil Diamond in. That's what we like to see. Son, get the party started. He's taking on a young man that a lot of people have got a lot of love and affection for. Frankie Stringer making his professional debut very shortly. Tickets tonight is Frankie Stringer, former Tri-Nation gold medalist, national champion. Frankie Stringer making his professional debut in his home city, Liverpool. It's been a difficult one for him this evening because he's been down as the float. And obviously with various fights going the distance and knockouts here, there and everywhere, he's been unsure as to where he will feature, but he's been given a prime slot. And the professional journey of Frankie Stringer under the tutelage of Joe McNally, you just saw him touch gloves with his main man there as he stands in front of us here on the ring canvas, is about to get underway. As I said, his opponent, Simas Valasinas, has only been stopped 8 times through 110 fights, so it's going to be interesting to see how Frankie approaches this. Big fight for him, 4 rounds in the lightweight division. Let's get his and his opponent's formal introductions with our MC, Melissa Santos.
The following contest is set to 4 rounds in the lightweight division. Introducing first to my left in the blue corner, he is a seasoned veteran from Lithuania, Simas Bolosinas. And his opponent, to my right in the red corner, weighing in at an official weight of 139 pounds and 2 ounces. This is his debut with ProBellum as a professional. From Liverpool, he is Frankie Stringer.
Right, lads, you know, expect from you both, you obey me instructions at all times. When I tell you to break, you both break clean. Defend yourselves at all times, and the best luck to you both. Touch gloves. Well done.
Here we go. We've had some very good young talent on this card this evening, and a lot of people around these parts speak very highly of this young man. Obviously, you can just see him getting final instructions from his coach, Joe McNally. Frankie Stringer making his professional debut against Simas Valasinas. Let's see what all the hype's about. Establishing that jab nice and early, Frankie Stringer, and getting to work. Lovely combinations to the body. Doubling up the jab as well.
Really good amateur junior boxer at the Rotunda ABC, Frankie Stringer. Up to the turn professional. Very, very good fundamentals and good basics of boxing. And I'm a bit biased about the Rotunda Boxing Club, but it's the one thing that they instill in the kids, isn't it, Nick?
Big right hand there.
Just speaking about Frankie to Joe McNally this week. Usually Joe keeps his cards close to his chest. I don't even think Joe owns a mobile phone. He's one of those types of characters. He doesn't say much in public, But I tell you what, when I asked him about Frankie and his potential, his little face lit up and he was grinning from ear to ear. So super excited to be on the journey with this young man, because nothing but great things being spoken about him in the gym.
His manager's a bit busy tonight. He's over the other side of the pond in New York preparing
for
the fight.
Your brother,
this Saturday coming. Good shot there from Sugar.
For those that don't know what Paul's referring to, he's referring to
Paul's younger brother, Liam, who's in action next week. Madison Square Garden, the destination. Jesse Vargas, obviously Liam, got big aspirations once again to get back into world title contention. And a win against someone like Jesse Vargas, especially on American soil, will go somewhere in order to push him forward. Some card to be on that next weekend as well, in the historic fight between Serrano and Taylor. Should be an absolute cracker.
Great show, great cards, great venue. And a brilliant city as well.
What time's your flight, big boy? Come on, come on, do a bit of Boston.
Tomorrow morning.
There he is. Bring us something back, eh? From the Big Apple. Should be a good weekend next weekend. But right now, it's all about the guys here in Liverpool and Frankie Stringer. Hand speeds there, shot selections there, footwork's there. As you boys have pointed out, the fundamentals that he's learned, obviously, under the tutelage of everybody at the Rotunda, most certainly there.
Whips those long levers in, doesn't he? He's quick, he's accurate, spiteful puncher.
He started a bit fast, but it's expected.
Yeah.
Professional debut. You're going to come out fast, come out the blocks. You've all been guilty of doing that. But there's not been much wasted with him apart from the elbow shots. Got to try and get round those elbows or bring it like that with a nice little stab to the body to bring the elbows narrower to then go wide. End of the round.
Yeah, not too much coming back from Valasinas, as you would expect from a journeyman of his nature. You know, 100 losses on his record, but only a handful of stoppages in those losses as well. Coming into a fight like this, Paul, is that something that Joe McNally would have maybe explained to Frankie Singh and said, listen, we ain't got to go for the knockout here. This kid doesn't get knocked out. It's about doing the four rounds and enjoying the four rounds.
Yeah, I think the advice will have been just enjoy it, and he has to enjoy it. Stay sharp, stay switched on, stick to what you've been practicing and learning in the camp that you've had since you turned professional. And enjoy it, above all enjoy it. You have to enjoy it, you know, it goes by so quick, and in your debut against someone like this, as long as you're sensible, careful, switched on, you can enjoy it and still get that win.
Do you remember now, thinking back to when you were first starting out and all the old boxers that said, Paul, just enjoy it, and now you're that guy?
I hated every second of it as well, and yeah, now I'm that boring old guy telling them to relax.
Enjoy it.
I sprinted to the referee after the four-round decision just to make sure that I won it.
Second phase underway. Frankie Stringer on his professional debut.
Good shot!
Big shot from Frankie.
Well, Valasinas felt that.
As I said a moment or two ago, Valasinas, 110 fights through his professional career. He's only been stopped 8 times. It would be some statement for Frankie Stringer on debut.
Staying sensible, though. Staying smart and relaxed. He's not going for it, which is good. He's landed the shot. He knows he can hurt him.
Good work from Frankie again.
As I mentioned before, we've been in the gym with Frankie a lot. He trains alongside my brother Liam. So I've watched him sparring since he turned over into the professional game. Watched them on the bags and the pads with Joe McNally and Declan and the team that he has there in the Rotunda. He's keen. He's a student of the game, he watches a lot of the boxing now, he follows it. He's always eager to learn, always asking for advice, always taking tips on board, he listens to his coaches, which is a good sign. He's got all the good signs to make a good professional so far.
Shot selection's on point as well, mixing it up. Whips a nice left up to the body. Get that one a few minutes?
Yeah. That's a Rotunda trademark, that's not me, that's a Rotunda.
There it is again.
There it is again.
Beautiful stuff. Good work from Frankie Stringer. Stop. jab. Possibly. That's just showing how durable he is.
Yeah.
Weather the little storm early doors. Keeping Frankie honest. Good stuff. And he's listening. You can tell that he's listening because we're fortunate enough to be very close to his corner, listening to the instruction that's coming his way.
You can see him nodding and saying yes every now and then to the corner as well, which is just sparring habits carrying over into an actual fight. But he is listening. As you mentioned yourself before, Adam, good shot selection for someone so young.
Hurt him then.
Really good stuff.
Seen this then, that body shot, that right through.
But then not getting happy with the head. Putting that work in downstairs, really good stuff.
We mentioned about like camps and gyms and the fighters around you that you're training with. He's training in the Rotunda. Now, Buddy McGate will be based there with Callum Smith when he's here, so he's had Buddy in the gym.
Got
he's
going Joseph. A little bit here, Frankie. Good finish to the second round, really good stuff. Listen, coming up in a moment or two, you're going to see Peter McGrail in action. He's backstage with Radio Raheem. Let's hear from him.
In boxing, there are few brothers that have made world history. The Spinks, the Klitschkos, now the McGrails. What do you intend to do, you and your brother, in the sport of boxing?
Just keep winning our fights, keep training in the gym every day. Paul Stevenson and the Humphreys at Everton Red Triangle. Bring brilliant nights to Liverpool. As Prebellum, this is the first night in Liverpool, so looking forward to many more nights to come and just loads of wins and loads of knockouts and in the future, next few years, loads of belts.
Well, your last time out, you got a two-round stoppage. Your brother got a first-round stoppage. Can we look for the one-punch knockout tonight?
1,000,000%. That's obviously what every boxer goes for, but all the main thing is that come out of the ring healthy and we come out with that win, and that's what I'll be getting tonight.
Well, it's a pleasure to watch you at the beginning of your career and see what is in store for the future. Radio Raheem with Peter McGrail.
Peter's still to come this evening. He's next up, and then, of course, top of the bill, interim WBO Bantamweight Championship, Paul Butler taking on Jonas Soto. Big right hand from Frankie! Brilliant big right hand from Frankie Stringer landing on Seamus Valisinas, who manages to stay on his feet, took it well. The Lithuanian, who's just proving why you get so much work. Real tough, real durable. But Frankie Stringer is going through the repertoire on this professional debut and showing glimpses of some real class.
I mentioned before, just before we went to the break there, to speak to Peter McGrail, you know, he's got so much advice and knowledge around him from all the fighters and the coaches at the Rotunda, and it's a really good setup at the moment. He's benefiting from it.
Very much so. He's putting it all into practice tonight underneath the bright lights. And the fans that have turned up here at the M&S Bank Arena are getting a little bit of a treat. I really enjoy the way that he just mixes it up. Some of that body work that he's putting together is some top quality stuff. He's keeping a very honest journeyman honest. He's clipped him just above on the temple. He's still on his feet. He's Velocinas. Fantastic conditioning from the Lithuanian.
That's the shot, the right hook just around the ear. Right around the side of the guard.
Don't know if Velocinas is enjoying this too much. He keeps nodding, he's smiling away. Looks like he's having a whale of a time. But something tells me that this young man is causing him a right headache.
What I like about Stringer is it's the shot selection, of course, it's the power, of course, it's the way he moves his feet and cuts down the ring so well. What, you know, what really excites me? He looks like he hasn't got his man strength yet. And you know when that strength kicks in, this kid's going to be formidable.
Yeah, absolutely. He's got a long way to go yet before he fills out, as you mentioned, and it's a great point.
He picks the shot so well, and like you said, with a little bit more size, and as Nick worded it, man strength behind him, there's going to be a few kids going over.
I also like how patient he's been when he's had Valisinas hurt.
Absolutely.
He's stayed patient, he hasn't gone for it. I certainly did. You know, every single time, 30 fights in, I'm still going for it.
That's because you're a lunatic.
Exactly. But it takes a lot of patience and discipline to not actually go for it when you've got someone hurt.
Another big right hand. I know that was partially caught on the gloves. from the Lithuanian, but he most certainly felt it. And another one. Really good stuff, this, from Frankie Stringer, who's going through the repertoire, right hand, left hand, head, body.
Sensational stuff.
This kid's feet are absolute mustard.
Mastering range really, really well.
It's not often you see, you know, guys like journeyman, experienced journeyman like Velicidus, looking to hold on, but there was a few times there he was desperate to hold on. Just see there, just working his way back in. Look at Athens Stringer, wow! Right round the outside, just using that reach advantage that he's got.
Listen, Velicidus is absolutely delighted this is only four rounds. Fantastic performance so far from Stringer. It's going to be interesting to see how he approaches this final third, final 3 minutes, should I say. Because in almost every round, he's landed something that stung his opponent.
And that shot then, it kind of landed around the back of the heel, Velicidus, but as he stepped back, his legs almost let him down. That's true power.
Get on the vegetables, Frankie Stringer. Get that man strength, sunshine. That's what's next for you, because you can flip in box, lad. Right, let's have a look at this. 3 minutes to go. Really good stuff so far. Oh, that was naughty. He gave him a little look with a jab, slipped his leg back, and then bosh, beautiful stuff. Really good overhand right from Frankie Stringer. Going through the repertoire tonight. How old's this kid?
He's a kid, he's a baby.
I'm telling you.
You see him
looking at the corner and talking.
That's what I mean. He's a good kid, he's a nice kid, but he always wants to show that he's listening and taking the advice on board that people give him.
The combinations that he's putting together are superb. And again,
excellent shot.
Whether he leads off with a left or he leads off with a right, doesn't matter, does it?
No.
Really good. I apologise if you, whatever you're consuming this around the world, and you're just thinking that you're listening to a Frankie Stringer loving. But for the last 9 minutes, on a professional debut like this, it's very hard not to get excited about what might come of this young man. If he stays on the straight and narrow, keeps learning with the people that he's getting to learn with on a day-by-day basis, he's going to go a long way. Minute 30 left of this professional debut. Hopefully you've enjoyed it as much as us. Nice right to the body. Still to come this evening, don't forget. Peter McGrail, you've just seen him talking to Radio Raheem backstage. He's going to be in the ring as he progresses in the professional game. One of the very best amateurs that we've produced out of this country. He's recently turned over after Tokyo Olympics, and then we've got the WBO Interim Bantamweight Championship. Paul Butler in action against Jonas Sultan. What a fight that will be. Butler, the bookies underdog, aiming to become a two-time world champion. First time was 8 years ago in this very division, and he gets an opportunity tonight for the Interim Championship, which may, if the WBO stick to the word, be upgraded at some point in the not-too-distant future. You're watching Frankie Stringer go through the repertoire on his professional debut.
I'm a fan. Get me a T-shirt. I am all in.
Get me a T-shirt, indeed.
Honestly.
We've had a debate all week for the last month. What can be his nickname? And what ring music should he come out to? And I was dying to put Sister Sledge Frankie on for him, but he wouldn't let me.
Oh, nice, nice. Good talk. I'm going to go for Stringer the Slinger. That's what we're going for. Get him in there. Brilliant performance. That's getting a round of applause from me. Really good professional debut. The only thing he didn't get was a stoppage, but he stung his man in every single round, Paul.
Talks really well. Happy with that, impressed with that. And I made up for the kids. He's a really nice lad. He's just made his professional debut in his hometown on a good time slot as well.
I thought he looked great. Get me down the rotunda Monday morning if he's back in. I'd pay to watch that kid spar.
Stringer the Slinger, ladies and gentlemen. Get that tattooed on your neck. Great stuff, great stuff. Great debut from Frankie Stringer. Two fights still to come this evening. Get excited. Peter McGrail, who many say around these parts could be the best of the lot to come out of the Tokyo Team GB team. he continues his professional assault against Uriel Lopez. We saw Uriel Lopez recently, didn't we? Up in, it was in Sunderland against Mark McKeown, and they delivered one of the best fights that we've seen in recent time. If we get half as good as that on the card a little later on, you're in for a bit of a treat. But right now, let's get this made official, shall we, with Melissa Santos.
After going the distance, we take it to the referee scorecards for the final decision. The referee sees it 40-36 in favor of the winner, Frankie Stringer.
I tell you what, I love the drama from Melissa there. Love that. You've got to build it up, haven't you? It were a foregone conclusion, but you've got to build it up. Well done, Mel. Great stuff. Great performance from Frankie Stringer. Professional debut done. Look at Joe Mack. He wants his picture. Come on, he wants a team shot. Oh, boy. Our camera guy here at the side here, David Cavan. Come on, David, you old sailor, you. Get that in there, son. There you go, lads. Get the picture done. Get the mementos, because a lot of people are going to want to remember that professional debut. It's going to be a phenomenal ride with him.